This video is made possible by the realistic online game War Thunder. Check out this game through the link in the description below. Going through that link will not only support this show, but you'll also get a free premium tank or aircraft and 3 days of premium time as a bonus. And let's get into it. So in the video today, we're answering a viewer question because Peter R. asks us, if I had to, what parts of my body are healthiest to eat and offer the most caloric benefit? Essentially, what parts of me should I eat first to maximize my survival chances in some extreme situation? And also, what seems to be a separate question, would eating my feces be of any benefit? Well, of course, how long... Dude. While how long one could survive without food and water varies dramatically based on exact scenario, on the more pressing issue of water, it would appear that if someone stopped consuming this life-sustaining liquid at all, including not getting any from food, their death would generally occur within a maximum of about 14 days. This grim figure has been gleaned from data collected from the notes of terminally ill or end-of-life patients in hospitals who forego artificial sustenance and their bodies are slowly allowed to die. In most of these cases, the individual is either bedridden or in a coma, meaning their caloric and water needs are potentially minimized, so this seems like a good, rough upper limit. Unfortunately for our thoroughly average 5 foot 9 inch, 195.5 pounds everyman named Jeff, who is about to find himself in rather dire straits, death for him is likely to occur much, much faster. Beyond the fact that he's likely to be more active than a person in a coma, these figures don't necessarily immediately apply to him because of something known as adaptive thermogenesis. Adaptive thermogenesis, other than sounding exceptionally cool, is the term used to describe a unique quirk of physiology, which is often colloquially referred to as starvation mode. In a massively oversimplistic nutshell, sure to trigger more than one medical professional in the comments below, when the body is put on a restrictive diet for a significant length of time, it adapts to function less optimally, but at least still function, lowering the sustenance requirements it needs in a variety of fascinating ways that would take an entire video of its own to cover. Since terminally ill people and people in comas are typically already in this state when their sustenance is completely cut off, in some cases at least, likely survive longer than poor old Jeff, who, if he was randomly cut off from sustenance without warning in a survival situation, would probably not make it more than about 3 or 4 days. Of course, Jeff could last longer if he ate something, because many foods actually contain quite a lot of water, which is his most pressing need. While body parts are among those foods items that are jam-packed with H2O, that liquid was already in Jeff anyway, so there is going to be no benefit to consuming his own body part in this situation, unless, of course, the limb just happened to have gotten lopped off outside of his control and he wants to recoup what he can from that lost appendage. But now let's say that Jeff has an unlimited supply of water. Now he just needs some food, which the human body is literally made of. Thus, Jeff targets those sweet, sweet calories locked within himself. How many calories? Well, figures on this will vary wildly based on the individual in question, as you might expect. However, for a ballpark average for an everyman such as Jeff, he probably has about 80,000 calories in him, at least according to figures compiled by one Dr. James Cole at the University of Brighton. Dr. James Cole is probably on some weird-ass watch lists. As for the legs, again, with the caveat that this can vary wildly based on a specific individual, for a ballpark average, each leg contains around 7,000 to 8,000 calories, enough to sustain Jeff comfortably for around 3.5 days. If Jeff got really desperate, he could cut off one of his arms, which would net him an additional 2,000 or so calories. Essentially, another day of comfortable eating. We're gonna leave Jeff that other arm because, well, he needs it to perform the surgeries as well as cook and eat things. But Jeff could technically also remove a lung, a kidney, 70% of his liver, his gallbladder, his appendix, his spleen, and his testicles, because these are all things that can be removed from the body without technically killing you. It's important to note here that we did stop short of calculating the caloric value of a human penis because, well, come on, we have to leave Jeff with something to do while he awaits rescue. Okay, so using the data from the aforementioned British professor, and when needed, supplementing his calorie content numbers with animals with comparable organs to our own, this would all provide roughly 3,000 or so calories, give or take. Finally, if Jeff took the bones from his severed limbs and boiled them in water, he could create something akin to bone broth, which contains about 130 calories per liter. It turns out that you can make about a gallon of bone broth with around 7 pounds of bones. Your skeleton makes up about 15% of your total body weight, and your legs and a single arm constitute just shy of 40% of your total weight. Taking Jeff's weight, which we've already established as being 195.5 pounds, Jeff's legs and arms would provide around 12 pounds of bone, or enough to make a gallon and a half of bone broth, which amounts to about 900 calories. Being resourceful, Jeff isn't going to stop at limbs, organs, and bones, though. After all, a byproduct of eating produces another food source. Feces. Unfortunately, there's not been any study done that we could find telling us definitively the caloric content of human poop. That said, from limited studies we did find on human poop's nutritional makeup, and from many more done on mice feces, it would appear on average feces contain about 10% of the calories eaten previously, with the caveat that this does vary based on a variety of factors. Work with us here, people. If you really want to do more research on finding out the calorie content of human poo after a human has been eating their own legs, arms, and organs, well, we're gonna leave that to your search history, because ours is already a train wreck. In any event, if Jeff consumed in the ballpark of the 2,000 to 2,500 calories per day to maintain his original physique before he found himself in this little predicament, his poop may contain as many as 250 calories. Contrary to popular belief, his poop would also be reasonably safe to eat, provided he kept it fairly sanitary after squeezing it out. And we should also point out here that the 5-second rule isn't really a thing, and a dropped turd is most definitely going to pick up some icky things from the floor. So, doing the math, if Jeff literally cut off or removed every extraneous part of his body, say for a single arm, and then ate his excrement, he could conceivably find himself with a total of around 20 to 22,000 calories, or around 10 days of comfortable sustenance. And also, bonus here, with the loss of each body part, there's fewer calories needed to support the remaining body, meaning Jeff's going to be able to stretch things out even further in this little fantasy land that we've created. Of course, in a real-life scenario, slicing yourself up would, by definition, do severe damage to your body, expose yourself to infection, result in a loss of blood, and hence reduce your hydration level, and just generally place a lot more demands on your body to keep on going. When traumatically injured, your nutritional needs actually go up. And in the end, your body already has you covered. You see, it turns out, beyond attempting to get more efficient about caloric usage naturally, if you stop giving the body enough to function optimally, the human body is also amazingly efficient at using stored sustenance in your various bits, particularly fat, muscle, and to a lesser extent, bone. Of course, after all this, Jeff's body fat percentage might be on the lean side, and his lifts on the bench press may be vastly reduced from their former, no doubt, beast mode levels. But of course, on the plus side, he'll be alive, and he'll have his parts of his body still attached to him. Thus, as with so many of life's problems, the solution was inside himself all along, including the feces and urine, which could potentially give a very slight benefit the first time if he wanted to muscle them down. So, to sum up the question posed by our now favorite viewer, while certainly your body contains a lot of useful calories should you consume them directly, it turns out it's already really good at more or less eating itself without you needing to cut anything off. That said, should you be stranded with a pleasantly plump companion in such a survival scenario, you might want to go check out our video, "Do People Who Resort to Cannibalism in Survival Situations Get in Trouble? Knowledge is Power." And you know what else is powerful? Vehicles from wars. And that's why this video is brought to you by War Thunder. That transition was a real stretch. War Thunder is a realistic, free-to-play military vehicle combat game. War Thunder is available on PC, PS4, and Xbox One. But you only need one of those devices, and you don't need to pay for it. You just download it and play. In this game, there are over 1,200 historically accurate vehicles, all the way from the 1920s to the 1990s. They're all carefully built and incredibly detailed, and all of the physics that's really been sweated over, so you know it's good. Plus, sound, also pretty excellent. And look, you can just jump in for a quick arcade game, useful if you don't have much time, or you can play realistic and go for some more challenging tactical stuff. Or, if you're really hardcore, if you've got a beast mode, there's always simulator, but I've never played that because I don't like getting my ass whooped over and over again. So join us on the battlefield for free using the link in the description below. Doing that supports this show, and it also gets you a free premium tank or aircraft, and 3 days of premium time is a bonus just for registering. And as always, thank you for watching. That was an intense one.